The young boy was staring down the barrel of a golden gun. The gunman's finger was on the trigger and his hand held steady. The child could see the glint of the angry bullet aimed at his forehead and could not tear his eyes away from the pistol. He even noticed the other five bullets sleeping peacefully in their chambers. Sweat poured out of the child's body. The man cocked the pistol and the boy heard his mother's screams. No, 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 no. His brain fought to ignite his fight or flight instincts, but all the young child could manage was a glance at his mother across the dinner table. Her face echoed her son's shock and fear. Her eyes locked on the young boy, and she could see one golden pistol reflecting in his giant eyes. The other gun was directed at her heart. Fear and desperation pulled the tears from her eyes. They slid down her melanated face with endless encores. She could not lose her son. She could not lose her life. It could not happen. Who was this man? Why did he want to kill them? She stared at the mysterious figure wielding the weapons. His face could haunt nightmares. His eyes screamed that he was a murderer. Here he sat at their dinner table, threatening her family in their home, and there was nothing she could do about it. Her husband's name escaped her lips as a whisper. Theodore. Theodore reached across the table and grabbed his son's hand and assured his wife that everything was going to be okay. He would make everything okay. He had to, because he loved his family and he would do anything for them. He enjoyed every minute they spent together. He cherished every meal with them, except this one. This was the first dinner with his family that Theodore regretted. There were so many things about this moment that he wished he could change. He knew something was wrong from the moment he began praying over their dinner and heard that knock on the door. But he still got up, walked away from his family, and went to that door. If only he didn't open it. But he did. The door slowly opened and the man on the other side brought tsunamis of terror to the surface. He wore a cloak with a black hat that hung low over his brow. The visitor brushed past him and into their home. His spurs applauded each boot step with a chorus of clinks. He approached their dinner table and placed two golden pistols delicately on the table as he sat down and glared at his family. Another figure came to the door and stood behind his son. This man placed a tattooed hand on his son's shoulder, holding him to the spot. They were surrounded. Theodore stared back at the dark figure across the table and begged him to leave his family alone. The invaders never said a word. Instead, the man with the golden guns picked each one up from the dinner table and aimed them at his wife and child. He pleaded with him to leave them out of it and that they go for a walk outside. The gunman aimed both guns at his wife and he pulled the triggers. The light blinded her, but the impact of the bullets crashing into her chest threw her body out of the seat and onto the floor. Her son screamed, "No, no, 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 no!" Her husband lunged forward and cradled her head in disbelief. She was gone. His wife was dead. Anger fueled his leap towards the gunman, but two more bullets exploded out of the gun. The sound echoed through their home. The child screamed again. Both of his parents lay dead on the floor. The boy yelled and wrestled against his family's assassins, but the scorpion tattooed man held him down. The gunman revealed a switchblade that gleamed menacingly in the light. He leisurely approached as the child twisted and fought in his seat. The man angled the blade so that the child could see his own fear in the reflection. He placed the blade over the boy's stomach, then slowly raised it to his neck. He paused, relishing this moment. The boy was about to die. But suddenly, he decided to lift the blade to the child's head. Pain exploded in his forehead, blinding pain. It was as if the man was trying to dig through his skull and into his brain. Blood dripped down his nose and onto his shirt. Once they finished branding a deep cross in the boy's forehead, they left as quickly as they arrived and they never said a word. But the pain that they left behind could not be silenced. This was the most important dinner of Nat Love's life. This was the last meal with his parents. He would replay this day over and over. He watched them die at the hands of Rufus Buck in his nightmares. He relished them because they stoked the hate and rage within him. That moment changed his world. He became a man with a sole purpose, revenge.